all gave some, and some gave all, and some stood through for the red, white, and blue, and some had to fall. And if you ever think of me, think of all your liberties and recall. Some gave all.
What's up, mister?
Hey, what's happening? Happy Memorial Day.
What's up, people? We're paying respect to those who served and lost their lives and gave us this freedom to do what we want to do. Thank you.
Like barbecue.
Love it.
All right.
And we respect
it. See you guys in a bit.
We'll be there.
Welcome. It's a special edition of Neighborhood Watch. And I'm Pat.
I'm Matt.
I'm Abe.
I'm Brett.
Hey, we guys. We are here to celebrate a lot of things.
Okay? Happy Memorial Day. We had a...
In a way. I mean, Memorial Day, we'd like to say...
We got the B-18 flying over us right now.
Yeah. But we also like to say, you know, Memorial Day is not a happy occasion, but hope you're celebrating it well.
Yeah, it's a nice
And we're going to get into that with time. Brett here.
So I think on behalf of the Neighborhood Watch, you know, I think this holiday, you know, strikes a chord for all of us. And you know, we just hope that, you know, everyone remembers and, you know, that's why we're here. We're getting together and enjoying our neighbors, but remembering what the day is for.
Yeah, right? We got together today and had a barbecue, and we got to hang out with each other.
Good stuff.
Those guys that died, those women that died, they would have wanted us to be out here doing.
Well, they
stuff,
gave us so the
they yeah, gave us
chance
the
to do this, right?
Chance yeah. to do this. So, amen. Thank God you. Bless America.
Thank
right.
You
and thank you so, for your service, sir.
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah. Not a service day. Well, okay. Thank you, though. Thank you. But it's
a memorial.
It's a memorial for those that passed and gave. And so thank you.
We got you.
So
we got you.
We're thinking of you.
All right. So
we went to the Art Wind Festival this weekend. Yeah. I went on Sunday. Abe went today.
Yeah, we went today. It's great.
It was a good time. They got a lot of people there. It was windy, so a lot
I'm
going to
tell you,
kites.
I didn't go because it was cold yesterday.
Yeah.
And rainy.
It was actually windy.
And it was windy. And I know it's a wind festival, but
man,
I don't want to go. And I don't want to pay $4 a ride for my kids to go around the circle on this ride. You guys rip us off for that shit. Stop. We'll bleep that out. But come on. It's all fun till you get to the rides. Abe spent $80 on rides.
Good job, Abe.
$80.
But where'd that money go?
And his kids, still aren't happy.
No.
Do they have a good time?
It's you know we
Bill Clarkson, it's on you.
We love the festival. We go every year.
Just kidding, Mel.
We go every year. It's a good time.
Oh, you do.
We meet friends down there. It's good. You gotta love the wind festival.
I'm you a Robin big, Hug down there.
I'm a proponent of the wind festival.
It's probably a major.
Abe came back saying he spent a lot of money on these godforsaken tickets for these slides.
They actually have a haunted maze that's three tickets, and it took 10 seconds to finish.
Three tickets or $20?
Capitalism. Man. So, you know, it was a fun time with your family
God
and friends.
Kim Jong-il.
And we got to enjoy. It was cold yesterday. Today was better.
Yeah,
right?
It was. It was a nice day today.
Yeah, I don't go in the cold.
So, you know, Pat stays in a warm
blanket.
Well,
it's not a pH thing. I don't go in the cold.
Okay, so regarding the cold. I mean, wouldn't
ice?
Couldn't it
ice
normally be super hot right now and not rainy? I mean, we got some weird weather going on.
We do.
It's just.
So you never know. You never know because a lot of they call it the wind festival. I've been a couple years and there's not a drop of wind. So
but I've been
I hope they took advantage of
I've been
the
there
wind
where
they
it's
had this
very
year.
Sunny and hot and windy.
Yeah.
So
I just make the best
art
of the
and
wind.
I don't know who would ever celebrate a wind festival like art festival. Great. Why would you want to honor the wind? Yeah. Blows all your shit over. Stop.
We got this canyon. It's like,
that's
it's like,
two bleeps tonight. We love you.
Hey, all right. Guys, so one thing I'd like to say is that, you know, we're having a good time.
Yeah.
And we're enjoying ourselves, and we actually had a good story I'd like to bring up. So while I was there yesterday, someone reached out to us that...
hey, Matt.
Yeah. And it's kind of weird, right? It's happened to a bunch of us. You know, we've got 3,000 subscribers now. So you get someone spotting you and saying, hey, are you Matt from Never Watch? Are you Abe? Are you Pat? Are you Brad? And it's kind of weird because you're like, yeah. And then, anyways, this to finish the story, they asked us, they saw our videos at City Center, and so they wanted to connect with us. They want to connect with us to help market some of the City Center lots, locations, like we did field work, and Brett and I went to Casa together. We're very pro City Center. We think it's a great place to connect. It's
getting better and better.
It's getting better and better. Yeah, so look out for some great things for the neighborhood to watch, you know, as we maybe partner.
I think we've said this, and we've waited patiently.
Yes.
And it's happening.
Yes.
Things are bubbling up. Like, it's bubbling
up, right? It's going to be a cool place, for sure.
Okay, so that's great. Awesome. Good stuff.
Yeah. It is good stuff, and it's going to get better.
Key stuff. That's key to what we're trying to do here in San Ramon. And then there's stolen bikes, right?
Yeah, that we're trying to not.
Well, somebody stole their bike at the City Center, but the guy didn't lock the bike up.
Yeah, so that's kind of his fault.
Yeah.
Coyotes.
Yes.
So here's the deal. There was a coyote sighting today about noon on the Iron Horse Trail by somebody else, right? Like, they posted, they're like, oh, we're walking by Del Mar between Pine Valley.
Okay.
And by the dog park. They're like, Del Mar dog park. We see coyotes. Didn't know. Okay. Yeah, so that was posted. So I have the pictures. We were leaving. Barbecue at 4 o'clock. And in that field, that open space between Pine Valley Devona,
Christmas tree farm,
and Broadmoor, which used to be the Christmas tree farm.
Yes,
if you didn't know that,
it's called the Christmas tree farm. Great, there's no Christmas trees there.
Right, amazing now. Christmas tree farm that the government took away from us.
Thanks.
But they did. The government said
it was nice Christmas tree.
It was great. The best Christmas tree farm ever.
Yeah,
go saw your trees down.
So good,
like Clark Griswold.
Yeah, exactly.
But in the open space, we saw a coyote, and we'll post pictures of the coyote.
Yep.
To me, it looked like the thing was a little emaciated, real thin.
Yeah, you can see the ribs.
You can see the ribs. I should have just taken it out. But
it definitely wasn't a fox.
This poor animal should be taken. It was wobbling like it was confused, like things should have been taken
out. Maybe rabies, right?
Yeah, I don't think rabies, but just probably hunger. Like, maybe it was looking for a mouse, but, you know, I love wildlife. We got to keep it going on here.
It was a homeless dog.
It was a homeless dog. We shall relocate the dog. Anyway, folks, that's my bit. We're going to post pictures of that. And
maybe not.
Yeah. God bless. God gave all, I gave some. Let's just get back to the theme.
Yeah. So, Brett. Go ahead. Before Brett, go.
Well, crazy, right? So let's keep saying my name. So school's about to be out, right?
Yeah, 4 days.
Holy cow.
4 days,
hey,
man.
We got some parking situations going on this particular street. Anyone know what that rule is? Because it's been a little talk.
I'm selling my...
I always get like a ton of people in front of my house.
I'm going to do two spots for $50 a spot.
That's a good deal.
Cal High graduation.
Yeah. And you're like, how far away? Like 50 yards.
Yes.
Yeah. Like, you don't get much closer than right here.
So, was that Friday?
Well, except for...
It's Friday.
Yeah.
All right. We'll go closest.
Stay tuned on that.
Friday. Park in Pat and Matt's driveway.
If you want to walk an extra 50 feet, talk to me.
Yeah. His is a couple dollars cheaper.
Yeah.
So it's a good idea, man.
Yeah. Someone posted, right? Don't park in the...
It gets nuts.
Don't get don't get a ticket. Right?
And we're talking about across for people don't hear. Across the street from Cal High for graduation. This Thursday, Friday?
It's Friday.
Because
actually, May 31st is grad night.
Is that it?
I just can't
$20.
Believe it.
Start with $20.
$20? I can fit two cars in my driveway.
We have premium parking.
Ours comes with bottled water.
Yeah, we'll give you a bottle of water.
Yeah.
No, seriously, on all seriousness, hit us up if you'd like to a primo spot.
Sandra Moon, we
love
you.
Sometimes you life is busy and you oh no, I need a place to spot. Park, and guess what? Matt and Pat's house and Brett's.
There you go.
Yeah.
And well,
and maybe Abe's.
PM&B's parking.
Little private cove.
It's PM&B's parking. We'll give you the Ferris Bueller treatment.
Yeah. Take the car.
Take the car, Joe. Right? If your car's hot, we're gonna run it out.
Okay. So let's get into some seriousness right now.
Okay, what else is going on?
I would like to, you know, Brett's been wanting to tell about a story.
Well,
he's been saying it a couple times.
Well, so anyway, it's Memorial Day. So it's kind of a, it's, you
I
know,
saw this man, he was over.
It's not just a 3-day weekend. It's a day to remember people that, you know, have
all those given, have
given their
lives.
All, given, yeah. Given everything they signed up for. And it unfortunately maybe happened. And so Santa Moon has one of their own, and it's Lance Corporal Kyle Crowley. And I did post something on my personal Facebook, but I think we're going to post it on our.
Yeah, we will. We'll put it on this page.
And it was just they set up a permanent memorial for Lance Corporal Kyle Crowley, who passed away early in the Iraq campaign. And he was very young. He was 19, signed up when he was 18. So that's about as young as that gets, really. And this is what the day's, you know, was really for. I mean, it's nice to have a 3-day weekend, but and thank you very much. It means a lot.
And you can tell it means a lot to our brother Brett. Like we celebrate. We're having a good time, having a barbecue. The unofficial kickoff of summer, but really what this means is, you know, we got to remember all those that have fallen that made this day possible.
I think people take, you know, they forget, oh great, it's a 3-day weekend, but why are we doing this, right? So if you just take the time to think of why you get to have a day off at work or have fun at barbecue and stuff like that, but remember what they did on our behalf so that we could live and be free.
Yeah.
So, thank you.
I explain it to my young kids, right? But it makes you actually, when you explain it to them, it makes you think, right? It makes you really think about what it, all the, everything that we should be thankful for. Right?
Yeah. And
gratitude.
I actually had the conversation with somebody and one of my kids, like, because there's Veterans Day, right?
Yes.
We celebrate all the veterans. And it almost seems like Veterans Day is more solemn, like as Memorial Day should be, but it's, you know,
it's like
Veterans Day is in the middle of the week, usually in November. You know, you're not, you know, this is also coupled. Memorial Day, unfortunately, has been coupled with the official kickoff of summer, barbecues. So I think in that respect, you lose a little bit of it, but. We got to just remember, guys, these guys, you know, I saw a great meme. It was the Normandy Deck guys going. It was like, this is their day at the beach versus your day at the beach, right?
Yeah.
Their day at the beach, they were getting their asses kicked, and they fucking...
Yep.
They, we'll bleep that out. They persevered. We might keep it in because we love America, bitches.
Yeah. Foghorn.
This is you're raw.
I'm giving Matt plenty of fodder.
Yeah. I'm working hard on editing tonight. I have to watch all of this thing.
He's got to work now to chew out my shit. Love you guys, Sandra Moon. Make it a great week.
Hey guys, again.
Yeah.
I think you also have a video to set this up.
Yeah. Maybe we'll send it like in a second piece, but it was just.
It wasn't done.
Yeah, it was a video of actually the putting when they recognized the original monument at Cal High. It's there now, so you could.
Yeah, you gotta go.
You know, it's called. You know what? Before sorry guys, I'm gonna get all historical, but before it was called Memorial Day, it was called Decoration Day. Before pre-1970, and it was when you would go in, basically, put some flowers down, and you know, on a tomb or a gravestone.
Right.
You've got a memorial over there, at California
Where's
High School.
At?
It's in the quad area.
The quad, okay.
Yeah, it's right there.
And go visit this guy. I don't know if the kids even know what it's about. Respect.
But throw a flyer down. So,
yes.
Just, awesome. Sorry. Well, I'm done with that.
It doesn't take much.
Guys, we will be back next week. Hopefully.
Oh, yeah.
So, Pat, take us home.
We're going to be back. Respect those that died for you. What else do we want to say? I got to stop cussing. It's been a fun weekend.
Hey, you know what,
guys? Hey.
Keep it classy. And
we got more on Trader Joe's coming your way.
Trader Joe's is huge. That gets gutted.
Yeah.
Guys,
Trader Joe's.
We love you.
You're
going to
see more of us at the city center.
Yeah.
TJ's coming.
We're the voice. We're the voices, baby. So peace out.
Tacos Chico, we're there for you. Fieldworks.
Hey.
Casa.
Casa. Peace out.
Fieldworks.
Thanks. Peace. Whoa,
though new to the Marine Corps, Kyle had the proficiency, intellect, and maturity of Marines many years his senior. Kyle was always eager to learn new things and assume greater responsibilities. In fact, though he was a junior in rank, he was selected to be a fire team leader after only 2 months with his unit, a leadership position normally held by someone with 4 years of experience. Kyle was a courageous and intrepid man. Indeed, on the day he and 14 other men were trapped in a heavy volume of enemy fire, it was Kyle who was leading the movement in his Humvee, though I am certain he never thought he would be ambushed. He fearlessly assumed the dangerous duties of the lead driver. Whenever anyone from 2nd Platoon talks about Kyle, they always mention how dedicated he was to the mission and how much he generally cared about his Marines. Kyle could always be counted on to be in high spirits, which we saw with him at Cal High, and motivated his men. He never grew tired. He never quit. He was a professional. That's the story.